Twitter, yeah.
Like,
I like this guy, man. Where are you from, America, yeah?
Canada.
Oh, is but it?
Apparently, I sound American. That's like.
I mean, to us, you know how it is, man.
Yeah, I know. It's fine. It's like, yeah, I can't tell the difference between, like, you know, I mean, I can tell, like, Irish from, like.
Can we come here
Welsh,
a little bit?
Because
I think the light will be better if we come just here. Is that right?
What?
Can we come just here a bit?
Oh, you want to film this now?
Yeah, that's all right. How's it going? What's your name, man?
It's Max.
Max, my name is Mohammed.
Yeah,
nice to meet you. Yeah.
Yeah.
So tell me, you're Canadian, yeah?
Yeah. What's we lost the other guy.
Yeah, I don't know where he went.
Right.
Yeah, of course. Sorry. Sorry about that.
Yeah, right.
Sorry, my friend. Yes. He wants us to stop, isn't he? Just,
yeah, yeah, cool.
No problem.
You can go like, against the fence if you want.
No.
All right.
I don't like going against the fence. So, yeah. Are you here for, like, are you a tourist here? Or?
Yeah, pretty much. I just wandered by.
Yeah, yeah. And so, what's your theological, like, what are you theologically convinced with? You're an atheist.
I would say agnostic, I guess, because I said atheist earlier, but then some guys caught me in a logic trap, so agnostic fits better.
No, but it's a humble position, agnosticism,
yeah.
Isn't it? So,
yeah.
Fair enough. No, I mean, it's good that I'm talking to you about this, because what I wanted to say first and foremost is, let's ask the overall question, yeah? Before we talk about human beings, I heard you talking about, like, kind of evolutionary type things with the other gentleman, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
But generally, I wanted to ask you, like, how do you explain us being here? How did the universe come into existence?
The most truthful answer I can give is that we don't have concrete evidence of any given means of creation of our universe yet.
Let me ask you a better question.
Okay.
Max, yeah?
Yeah.
This is the thing. This, seriously, yeah?
All right.
Whenever I speak to atheists, it always boils, obviously and rightfully so, down to the evidence, doesn't it, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. What is your truth standard? What for you is sufficient evidence? Generally speaking, in order for you to accept a thing?
In order for me to accept something as likely true, because I think if you have a truthful scientific view of the world, you'll never accept anything as 100% concretely true, right? Like, we've printed hundreds of thousands of books, and every single time we do it, we apply ink to a letter, and we press that letter into the page.
Yeah.
And so we print a word there. It is possible that one time when we apply ink to a letter and press it into a page, the book will spontaneously combust. I haven't seen it yet, you haven't seen it yet, but we can't say with 100% certainty that it couldn't happen, right? So
yes, yes.
What I'm operating from is a
probabilistic
basis. Yeah. So what I would accept as truth would be a body of research or evidence or a conversation that strongly suggests something. For instance, like, you know, we believe that aircraft will fly every time we apply a given amount of thrust to a wing with a given shape, because we've tested that hundreds of thousands of times, and every single time the aircraft takes off. It's possible that it won't one time, but the body of evidence suggests that it will.
Okay, I like that. I agree with that.
Okay.
Yes?
Yeah.
So in short, what you're saying is you accept what you could say is a probabilistic type reasoning, yeah?
Yeah.
So based on likelihoods, mm-hmm. you assess whether a thing is true or false, generally speaking.
Likely or unlikely, I would
say. Yeah, likely or unlikely. And obviously that varies in proportions depending on what you're talking about, yeah?
Generally speaking, depending on the size of the sample for evidence, right?
Okay.
So one experiment is a pretty weak proof. 100,000 experiments, fairly strong.
That's I agree with that, yeah? Very good. Now, let's apply this logic, because here what you've said is that you accept a probabilistic type reasoning, yeah?
Yeah.
Let's apply this to the universe and its construction or its creation or whatever you want to call it, mm-hmm. yeah? Or its inception. Mm-hmm. My standard question to you would be then, how did the universe come into existence? What's your answer for that, first of all?
My answer is that we're still working on finding the truth of that,
okay.
and that it's very difficult for us to find an absolute truth given the time scale that it occurred on. We have some theories that are looking increasingly likely, but we don't have an absolute answer. However, I don't believe that theists do either.
Okay, thank you. Now, you said you agree with the probabilistic type reasoning, yeah?
Yeah.
Do you accept that the universe is finely tuned?
Finely tuned?
And let me define what I mean by finely tuned. Yeah?
Okay.
What I mean by finely tuned is that the variables or the constants in terms of physics
yeah.
are set in such a way as to allow any life to exist. This is my definition of finely tuned.
Okay, now I would refute that by saying that on most planets that we've observed directly, because there are a lot that
No, but I'm not talking about planets, I'm talking about the universe generally.
Yeah, okay, so
yeah.
The universe generally is empty space. After that, it's ultra-hot gas giants, it's black holes, it's stars.
Yeah, so yes.
An incomprehensibly small portion of it is suitable for some life. That's a far cry from finely tuned for life to exist.
No, that's not correct, because you can the question of whether life is fit to exist in the universe is a dichotomous question. So it's either yes or no. So I would ask you, is the universe tuned or finely tuned for any life to exist in it, you would answer by saying yes or no. And if you say no, you have to substantiate that in the light of the evidences. No, no. Because if there's any kind of life that exists in the universe, no matter how small or insignificant in your eyes, that disproves your thesis. Do you understand the point?
I don't believe that to be true, but for the sake of continuing this discussion, I'll accept that a portion of the universe is a good location for life.
No, but let's not just for the sake of this argument, because what you've done here is you've given me no reason. Here we know that life exists on this universe, yes or no?
Well, yeah, we're standing here,
okay. We know that the universe facilitated that in terms of its constants and its physical properties, yes or no?
Sure, yeah.
Okay, fine. Now, where the life exists, how much life exists in terms of quantity, these are peripheral questions or additional questions or supplementary questions. They don't affect the question at hand, which is, does the universe or is the universe finely tuned for any kind of life to exist? And I'm not honing in on human beings and saying that human beings here...
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, I'm saying any kind of life to
does
exist.
Does the universe allow life to exist?
Yes, that's the question. Thank you very much. Now, according to the majority, according to almost, it's almost a consensus in science now, yeah? In terms of physics, that physicists, whether they be agnostic, atheistic, or theistic, acknowledge the fine-tuning of the universe. Now, Stephen Hawking says this in The Brief History of Time. Even Richard Dawkins says this. Many different people, obviously Martin Rees, who wrote the book Just Six Numbers, many different individuals, they make this claim, okay? My point is, when they say this, what they're effectively saying is that the constants in terms of physics are so finely tuned, had they been otherwise adjusted, the universe would not allow any kind of life to exist. And therefore, me and you couldn't have this conversation. Does this make sense so far?
Yeah, if the universe was tuned in such a way that life couldn't exist in it, then life wouldn't exist in it. That's true, but it's also kind of an end in itself.
Okay, now, my question is, probabilistically, because this was your, this was obviously...
Yeah, an argument from probability.
Yeah, your argument from probability. Yeah. This was your original point, wasn't it? So, probabilistically now, I'm asking you a very simple question. What is the probability that the universe could have randomly allowed for human life to, or any life to exist?
So this is like, could the room full of monkeys with typewriters eventually write Shakespeare thing, right?
No, because...
Well, no, it is. It's the same argument. I mean, it's different constituent parts, but it's the same core argument.
The only difference...
Let me answer your question.
Yes, of course. Sorry.
The probability is necessarily high enough for that to occur, because you accept that the universe is more or less infinite, right?
No.
You don't. You think there's an edge?
Well, do you think that the universe didn't have a beginning?
It may or may not have.
Wait, hold on. Because now, you're moving away from the scientific evidences. The majority of scientists clearly believe in the Big Bang and clearly believe in the expanding universe model.
That is not true. Those are both theories.
No, but do you not believe in that?
That's fine.
I'm not saying that you're compelled. I'm just saying, it's fine. I'm just saying, you don't have to accept those things.
Yeah. Okay, so here's the thing. You asked me if I believe that, like, what the probability is that the universe, when just interacting randomly with itself, would produce the conditions...
That wasn't what I said, by the way.
No? Okay, clarify.
I said, generally speaking, I didn't say interacting randomly with myself. That wasn't an insertion I made, Max.
Okay.
I said, generally speaking, the inception of the universe, yeah? Upon the inception, if you obviously believe in an inception or beginning of the universe, which you're saying you don't. Which you're saying you don't. But...
Well, no, I'm not saying I don't or I do. I'm saying I don't know.
Okay, fine. That's fair enough. That's a fair enough position. Max. That's a fair enough position. But what I'm saying is, you're saying, and you wanted to presuppose here for this conversation to continue, that the universe existed for an infinitely long amount of time. Now I'm saying, what's the proof for that? Since you're the one who's asking for proof, generally, I'm also in my right to ask you for your proof.
Sure. We don't have any proof based on carbon dating or any other scientific means that really extends much beyond the borders of this planet and maybe some adjacent ones. Like, as I understand it, we've taken soil samples from Mars, we've taken soil samples from the Moon. And in both of those cases, the soil samples that we took were able to be carbon dated back a certain amount of time. However, we didn't take deep core samples of the Moon or Mars, so we can't rightly say at this point in time whether we know as an absolute truth how old either one of those bodies are. Now, keep in mind, we've only touched two celestial bodies in our solar system, which is a limited part of a galaxy, so on and so forth. So, obviously, no scientist in their right mind would claim to have absolute knowledge of the beginnings of the universe. All we have are theoretical models.
Okay, thank you very much. But you're now presupposing a beginning of the universe, because what you said, just to summarize what you've said there, is that you don't have any evidences or proof to suggest that the universe was here for an infinite amount of time. That's what you said.
I certainly don't have proof.
Okay, you don't have proof. So that's the thing. To be honest with you here, Max,
yeah.
I have to be honest with you. Yeah? You seem like a very genuine guy, yeah?
Sure.
You seem to be deviating away from the principle that you've laid down for yourself. In the beginning of this conversation, I said to you, what is your standard of truth? What kind of thing would you accept? Yeah, of course, yes, explore the world.
Yeah.
But I was going to say, generally speaking,
yeah.
In the beginning you said that my standard of truth is a probabilistic one.
Yeah.
Yes? Based on evidences, you compile the evidences together and come to conclusions based on that evidences, based on those evidence or that data, or those sets of data, on whether you think something is probable or not probable.
Sure.
Okay. And then in the same breath or in a later statement, you said that I don't have any evidences for the fact that the universe was around for an infinite amount of time.
So especially if we can find it to me as a person standing here right now, but in a more general sense in terms of what I've learned, we do not have concrete evidence one way or the other.
Thank you very much. Okay, so if that's the case, why would you put that as a presupposition? It's very odd. So why would you assume that the universe here existed forever?
I didn't.
You said, no, you did.
It may have.
Okay.
There's a very great gap, and we should be precise about this. There's a very great gap between saying that something is likely or unlikely, and saying it's possible, and also another gap over to saying that it's true.
Okay.
I did not say it was true.
No, I know you didn't say that.
I did not say it was particularly likely or unlikely. I said it was possible.
No, I like that.
It's
no,
possible the flying spaghetti monster's up there somewhere. So let's just be clear. I'm not saying that it's 100% true.
Do you know what is... Can I tell you and the people something right here and right now? Yeah?
Yeah, that's the purpose of this, isn't it?
Yes. No. Max, I need to tell you something.
All right.
I need to tell you something because, you know, and this might sound... I want you guys, like, generally to really picture what I'm saying.
Okay.
With infinity, literally, almost everything is possible. I'll tell you what I mean by that.
That's correct. No, you don't have to explain it. I understand.
No, but I just want just to make sure. Like you said, spaghetti monsters, yeah?
Yeah.
There is a probability, like, actually, it's not a probability. It's 100% the case that me and you, if the universe were infinite, me and you had this conversation before in Pluto and Mars and all of these different planets.
Well, hang on. Not on Pluto or Mars. It's
yes, no.
There's another universe very like
No, but hold on, hold on.
There are people very like us, had a conversation very like this.
No.
But it is not possible that
everything is possible. No. This is what I want you to understand. With the existence of infinity, because with it, people don't understand what infinity is. Infinity literally is everything becomes possible, literally. Now,
sure.
Yes.
There's an unending number of iterations of everything.
Thank you very much.
I suppose you could say that, you know, something very akin to this happened before. Sure.
No, this happened before in all the planets of the universe.
We don't know that because...
But that's happened. If everything is possible...
Happened. It could happen. It could have happened previously or it could happen in the future.
Yes. Thank you. That's right. That's correct.
Yeah.
So,
you can't make an absolute statement.
Yeah. No, fair enough.
You say no one can
You're right.
Infinity.
So it's either happened before or it's going to happen in the future. That me and you have this conversation in Pluto and Mars. No, but I know it sounds ridiculous. It sounds, conceptually, it is true. Yes, because all these things.
Absolutions, I don't know about that.
No. Absolutions, we're talking about past and present.
Yeah.
And future as well, yeah? With the existence of infinity, you've got everything is possible.
Mm.
Can you conceive this? Because I know it's difficult for people to conceive this.
It's not difficult for me to conceive, so don't.
Not you. But just generally, people find that. So, how is that possible? We don't understand. But with the existence, infinity is such a concept. That almost everything becomes possible.
Sure.
Like I could be flying in another universe.
All right, you made that point.
Thank you. Okay, now, no, because this is important, right? If I say to you that if everything, almost everything either has happened or will happen, then that would suggest here, this is important, that for you to say it's possible that the universe was infinite or it's possible this or possible that, in the context of an infinite universe, it's really neither here nor there.
Clear, have you accepted the premise that it is infinite?
No, of course not. I've already rejected that.
Right.
Yeah. I've rejected this. I've rejected. Yes, of course, my friend, yes.
There's nothing to repeat. It's just always evolution and then it's a progress.
Yes.
So it's not you cannot have the discussion, what you said, in the past or we're going to have in the future.
What? With the existence of infinity? Why?
Always is evolution.
But you understand, yeah?
Technically, every condition of this being the same.
Maybe in 2 million human being doesn't exist no more. He's having another
spaceship. Anyways, but thank you very much for your contribution. Is there anything you want to add? Anything more? Okay. But you understand the argument, the line of argument, yeah?
Sure. I would add one point, though.
Yes, go ahead, please.
If the universe is infinite,
it
is possible that this conversation will repeat or has occurred in the past. but this exact one in this exact point in the universe physically, and also at this exact point chronologically, could not reoccur.
No, no. Who said that? Why? Who made that? Who made that condition? No. Tell me the reason why. With the existence of infinity, there's
because no... theoretically, even in an infinite universe, you... Ah, you know what? Maybe you could have a repeating point in space.
Of course maybe. You can. Yeah, you definitely will, actually. Okay, so this infinity thing, by the way, which doesn't exist in the real world.
Okay.
I don't even believe infinity exists in the real world. Infinity doesn't exist in the real world.
We don't know that.
No, I mean, mathematicians have spoken on this. Like Hilbert, you know the Hilbert Hotel example?
Go ahead.
You know where he said that if you had a hotel with an infinite amount of rooms and two people left the hotel, yeah? How many people do you have in a hotel? Infinity minus two. How can you have infinity minus two? That's a contradiction in terms.
It is, but if you accept that...
There's no way you can have infinity minus two. That's a contradiction in terms. Right, if two people came into such a hotel, Hilbert says, what do you have then? Infinity plus two.
Does the hotel have infinite rooms?
Yeah.
Does everything around the hotel have infinite
rooms? It's the hotel, yeah.
Is there an infinite number of people?
Yeah.
Is there a universe outside the hotel?
this is the presupposition, yeah. So, do you get what I'm saying here? This concept of infinity, when you scrutinize it from a philosophical perspective and a mathematical perspective, it doesn't work.
If you escaped infinity and then gone back into it, it defeats the fact that the hotel is infinite. Because you can't
exactly.
leave it.
Thank you. That's correct. So, it's a contradiction in terms.
Yeah, okay.
So, the concept of infinity as applied in the quantifiable, tangible realm is something which actually cannot exist. It's not that it just doesn't exist. Is something which conceptually, mathematically, philosophically, cannot exist.
How do you know that?
For the examples I've just given you, but it's not my example, it's the mathematician's example. It's Hilbert's example. It's called Hilbert's hotel,
but
or whatever it's called.
There's an assumption in that example, which is that the two people can leave the hotel.
Yeah, well, why not? Why shouldn't that be the assumption?
Well, because if the hotel's truly infinite, then how would you get out?
Well, I mean, what's this and this? Why? How does that contradict that?
No, so you asked for...
Why does he have to be... It's not a prison, it's a hotel.
This is your infinite hotel.
But it's not. I didn't say it's an infinite prison.
You have two individuals inside of it. The next thing you say is these two individuals leave it. Thereby, the hotel is no longer infinite because there's an edge in the escape there. That is a finite hotel.
Okay, so that's exactly right. So what you've done there is you've correctly identified the contradiction of dealing with infinity, plus or minus dealing with
infinity. To me, it just means that example is flawed.
Okay, give me.
You can't take a flawed example
but listen,
and expand it to encompass the entire universe. And
no,
expect that to convince me.
No, what I'm saying is, give me. Okay, so in your case, I'm just going to ask you a question. Give me a quantifiable example of how infinity has existed in the real world.
You can't. That's the beauty of it.
No,
I mean,
sorry. No, sorry. No,
you. The beauty of it is quite understandable. Isn't that like a cop out? Like you're just escaping from. Yeah, you don't want to accept the truth.
Well, infinity is a concept.
So anything you can't understand is beautiful? Is that the...
No, that specifically is beautiful. The beauty to me of the infinite universe is that there are infinite possibilities, as you said. And you're trying to use this, although we haven't gotten there yet, to prove the existence of some sort of God, right? So can we jump a little closer to that?
I haven't even talked about God.
Okay. Well, what's your angle then?
Look, my angle is this. Look, Max, I've thoroughly enjoyed having this conversation with you, because you're not just like the normal... agnost or atheist that really doesn't know the arguments. You're well aware of the arguments. I'm sure you have a book there that you've been reading.
And not about this, but it is a book, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. I just saw something, a scientific name of the book, so I thought...
it is a science book, yeah.
Listen, Max. Today, we have laid basic premise, and we have agreed with that, and this is the beauty of it. I'll call this beautiful myself, yeah? We said that we both accept that something which has a probabilistic reasoning is something which maybe ought to be accepted.
Sure.
Okay. Now, going back, since I said to you, listen, you cannot prove the existence of an infinite universe. It actually contradicts the science of today, for the most part. Like the expanding universe model, it does contradict it. You can't say it doesn't. Because the expanding universe model, where you...